Will a Republican-led Senate be good for the Philippines and the rest of Asia? Philippine Ambassador to the United States, Jose Cuisia Jr. believes the country will continue to reap the benefits of military and economic support from the Republicans. North America Bureau Chief Wal Henson reports.
As Republicans celebrated their big win for snatching the Senate leadership, these kababayans were also tuned into the results at a town hall meeting in San Francisco with Philippine Ambassador to the U.S., Jose Cuisia Jr. Cuisia believes support to the Philippines and Asia will continue under a Republican-dominated Senate.
Both the Democrats and the Republicans have been quite supportive of the Philippines, particularly over the last maybe three and a half years. We've seen that we've gotten bipartisan support.
Some analysts said that Republicans are likely to focus more on Russia and the Middle East, but Cuisia says Republicans are committed to military support to the Philippines.
Chairman Ed Royce, who's chairman of the Foreign Relations Committee in the House of Representatives, is a Republican, and he has come out very strongly in support of ASEAN and in support of the Philippines. He also is very much in favor of that pivot to Asia.
He cites as an example the humanitarian assistance of U.S. troops to Typhoon Yolanda victims. Cuisia stresses the importance of the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, which was inked during President Obama's visit to Manila in April. This despite calls to scrap the EDCA along with the Visiting Forces Agreement, or VFA, because of the recent Jennifer Laude murder case where a U.S. Marine is the suspect. As the government moves forward following the midterm polls, Cuisia says another issue to look out for is Obama's long-delayed executive action on immigration reform.
We do have quite a number of undocumented Filipinos, and it would be to our advantage if a clear immigration policy comes out that would benefit these undocumented Filipinos.
Ambassador Cuisia called on the members of the Filipino community to be more united in the hope that it can become the most influential Asian minority group in the United States. He also hopes more Filipino-Americans can run for public office and help shape the future policy of this country. Paul Henson, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.